friends and associates. This is the behind the scenes for the Cursive Let Me Up video made by Coat Wolf. I'm Evan Glodell, a prominent Coat Wolf member. We call ourselves Coat Wolf. It's a group of friends who were like diehard filmmakers. And at one point, we decided we wanted to make a music video really badly, and we're like, who do we want to make a music video for? We all have been longtime fans of Cursive and loved them, and that was the first person we thought of. We're like, oh, we should make a music video for Cursive. But we didn't know how, because we don't have representation or even any business-minded people in our group. So we just went on MySpace and sent a message to the Cursive MySpace. And they got back to us and were like, okay, maybe you can do that. We really wanted to do it, so we put together this like test video of an idea we had for one of their songs and sent it to them to try and like get them excited. The first song we got from them was the demo version of Going to Hell. When the time came to finally make the video, they gave us different songs, and we picked Let Me Up because we all really liked it. We wanted to do this really weird idea for the video, the one that exists now. And so to try and pitch them on the idea, we made this concept art, like demo version, like animated version of the video, using drawings that Joel Sharp drew, right, who was also the cinematographer, and just like cheap animation, quick animation in After Effects. But it's almost funny because some of the shots are almost identical to the way the final video turned out, which was kind of fun. So we went crazy. We made this little animated version and gave it to them, and then they were like, okay, it's insane, but why not? Let's just fucking do it. And then we got to make it. So we presented them with that idea with the concept art thing, right? And then when Tim saw that, he got a bunch of ideas. So the idea actually was like almost like a full collaboration between me and Tim. And one of the things that we had this girl that he had sort of implied that he had killed her and done something to her. And so that was a really last minute addition. It was the day of. We were like finishing getting the car together here at Joel's house, and then we're online like calling all these models. And then this one girl got back to us right away, Amanda Lilly. And came out for the stuff where we're shooting in the pool, right? Like this pool, the water was so cold that when you put your hand in it, it hurt. And so we're all hanging around by the pool and we're like, we're cool, we're filmmakers. And the other guys are like, we're cool, we're in a band. and then we're like, you, this innocent girl, and we're like, get in that freezing cold pool right now and stay in there until you get hypothermia. So anyway, so we put the girl in the pool. And she froze, and we didn't have to. And then we can't afford underwater rigs, and so we ended up just using a fish tank. We took a fish tank and just like pushed it down in the pool. And the water was so cold that between takes, Amanda had to get out and run into the warm shower and stand there, and then run and jump back in the pool. And she did it, and she even did it. We messed up like two of the takes, and she went and did it again anyway. So thank you, Amanda. Yay! That was the shit. We got ourselves in pretty deep. Because part of the idea was that he was in this car, and the car had all these instruments and steam pipes and like organ pipes and speakers and stuff built into it that were kind of like like an automatic organ playing the song. And so we suddenly had to build this car, right? And we're on low budget. So we went crazy and we spent like 2 weeks to put the car together.
Evan, what is all this shit?
This is the car that we built for the music video for Let Me Up. So the idea, right, was to build this car that it had, we couldn't do all the sounds, but that represented a lot of the sounds from the song, so that the car was sort of like an auto piano that played all the music. But these pipes right here, they're supposed to be like sort of like organ pipes, and you know, but they run off steam, and they actually do make whistle sounds, but they're not very loud. And it's run off of this thing. There's this trigger right here, operates this to release steam from the whole system, and these three switches. One, two, three. Control these three guys right here. And the whole system is powered by this thing. This is a stainless steel, high-pressure stainless steel boiler tank, and there's actually a burner underneath. There's a coil of copper wires and a propane tank that runs it. And this actually boils water, and the whole system builds up pressure So it's all real. We're pretty handy, so we can build this shit and get it to work, but we don't really know anything about it. We're not trained, so we don't really know what's gonna blow up and what's not. And we told Tim that, but he didn't seem to care, because he's a sweet dude. So he was sitting right where Paul's sitting right now in the driver's seat, and the propane tank was right here behind him running this thing. And this thing has flames coming up this high sometimes off it. So the entire time we're shooting all the interior car stuff, spent an entire day in here with this thing running a shitload of pressure with hot boiling water in it, and these things shooting out hot water and steam on it. So then we have this panel, right? And this, the actual car stereo system that was already in the car, we were able to hook it up to a power amp in the trunk to run these two shitty speakers that we ripped out of some $5 speakers at the thrift store. And then this meter, that's just a voltmeter, is actually connected to the stereo system. So when you play music, these two speakers automatically go in time with the music, and this thing bounces to the time of the music. These are actually horns, right? It's like tweeters from an old speaker. And so there was this sound that goes like, right? And we were like, oh, we'll build a little spinning speaker that so it sounds like it's coming from this. This piece was mounted on the dashboard in the front window, but we ripped it out to get a shot towards the end of the day. And it just runs, see this plastic hose? The way this thing runs is you suck on it. So you have to suck onto the beat.
This is Joel's car, by the way. We totally fucked it for the video. He donated it in a weird way. All the Cobalt members want to say thanks to Saddle Creek and the band for giving us a chance to make it, because that was some sweet shit. And also, we hope you guys like the video. You probably do like it, by the way. Because if you're watching this, then you had to care enough to watch it. So you better have liked the video. Because if you didn't like the video and you're watching this, you're wasting your time. You know? So sorry about that for wasting your time if that's who you are. We love you. Goodbye.